mode. In command today, we have Ariana up front assisting you in the cabin and Kaya in the back. Please direct your full attention to the front for an important safety announcement. In preparation for departure, be sure all carry-ons are stowed in an overhead bin or underneath the seat, and that all seat backs and tray tables are in their upright and locked position. Because of our interest in safety, we would like to take a moment to explain the use of emergency equipment on board this Canadair Regional jet. Please remove your safety information card located in the seat pocket in front of you and follow along. To fasten your seatbelt, insert the flat metal end into the buckle. To adjust the fit, pull the loose strap away from you so that the belt is low and tight. To open, simply lift up on the faceplate of the buckle. Sudden change in the cabin pressure, the compartments above your seat will automatically open and an oxygen mask will be within your reach. Take the mask in your hand and pull down to start the flow of oxygen. The bag will not inflate, but oxygen will be flowing. Place the mask over your nose and mouth and secure it by placing the elastic strap over your head. Pull the straps tighten and continue to breathe normally. Continue to use the mask until a crew member advises you that oxygen is no longer needed. If you are seated next to someone that will need your assistance, please secure your mask first and then secure their mask. If you choose to wear a face covering, please remove the face covering before donning the oxygen mask. Two oxygen masks within the laboratories are in a retainer clip. Pull the mask out of the plastic retainer and place the mask over your nose and mouth. If you choose to wear a face covering, we do ask that you remove the face covering before donning the oxygen mask. In the unlikely event of a water landing, your seat bottom cushions have been designed as flotation devices. Pull up on the cushion to remove it and take it with you to the nearest usable exit. When exiting the aircraft, place your arms through the straps and hug it to your chest. The aircraft is also equipped with infant life vests. In the event of a water landing, the flight attendant will hand the infant life vest to the adult with an infant and provide further instructions. There are 6 emergency exits aboard this aircraft, which include the main cabin door through which you entered and the door directly across from it. 4 additional exits are located over the wings, mid-cabin, 2 on each side. Exit signs located overhead identify these exits. This aircraft is also equipped with emergency escape path lighting. In the event of an evacuation, these lights will illuminate. Follow the 4 lights to the closest exit and keep in mind an exit may be located behind you. Regulations require that you continue to observe the no smoking and fasten seatbelt signs at all times when illuminated. All passengers must comply with these lighted signs, posted placards, and instructions provided by your crew. Regulations also prohibit tampering with, disabling, or destroying any smoke detector in an aircraft lavatory. May we remind you that smoking, including e-cigarettes or smokeless tobacco, is not allowed on this aircraft or any American flight. We will be taking off soon. Once again, please make sure your large portable electronic devices are turned off and stowed. All small, lightweight devices must be switched to airplane mode and secured. Your tray table and carry-on items must also be stowed, and make sure that your seat bag is upright and your seatbelt is securely fastened. On behalf of the ground crew and this Phoenix-based crew, we would like to invite you to relax and enjoy the flight. We will be dimming the cabin lights for departure. On behalf of American Airlines, American Eagle, and our One World Alliance partners, we thank you for flying with us today. Flight time.